Hi, I'm Prof. Melko, PhD chemist and university professor. And today we're going to talk about measurements and uncertainty. An instrument is used to make a measurement, and really a measurement is just a number with units attached to it. But importantly in science, this measurement always comes with an uncertainty, and that's what we're going to talk about today. So some examples of measurements, you're familiar with these, but something like I am 2.2 meters tall, right? The volume of a water bottle is 1 liter. Coffee is 20.0 degrees warmer than the water. And where we put these decimal places actually have scientific significance, right? Scientists usually use the metric system, of course. Here in America, we don't, but most of the world does. Length will be measured in meters, mass in grams, and volume in liters. So those are the units that we mostly use. Now, the uncertainty is a measure of how well we know a particular value, right? So the instrument that we use might not be that precise, so our uncertainty is large. The better the instrument is, the less uncertainty we have, or the more certain we are. Okay, so the inexactness of a measurement is called uncertainty, and it's usually presented with a plus minus symbol. So I am 2.0 meters tall, plus or minus 0.1 meters. That's typically how it's done in science. I have this nice little flask here, tiny, but maybe you can read on there if I hold it really, really close, 10 milliliters plus or minus 5%, right? Don't drink the science. But that's a measurement of uncertainty. So each number in a measurement is certain except for this last number. So I might know the two, but this last decimal place is where I'm uncertain, and I list that uncertainty as plus or minus with that necessary unit. Okay, as an example, let's consider length. We're going to talk about length, mass, and volume. So let's measure the length of maybe a stainless steel rod that we might have in the laboratory. Okay, we have this ruler, it has 1 centimeter divisions, and we can estimate the length to one decimal place, right? We know this rod goes between 4 and 5, it ends between 4 and 5. So we sort of have to guesstimate 4.2. We know it's greater than 4, so we're certain in this 4 digit, but we're uncertain in this 0.2 digit. Right? We're pretty certain it's, you know, 0.1 to 0.3, but we're going to list it as 4.2 plus or minus 0.1 centimeter. Right? The uncertainty, of course, can be lower, or we can be more certain if we use a better ruler. Right? Now, this second ruler has, you know, 0.1 centimeter divisions, so we can look very closely and see that it's past 4.2, but before 4.3. So now we're certain in that 0.2 value, and the uncertainty moves to the next decimal place. Okay, so we can estimate the length to 2 decimal places now, and the uncertainty then is in this second decimal place. So I'd call this 4.25, that's my guesstimate, plus or minus 0.05 centimeters. So ruler B is more precise with less uncertainty. That's length. You can do the same with mass. Mass, of course, measures the amount of matter in an object. It's not the same as weight, right? Your weight will be different on the moon. Your mass will not be different. You'll have the same amount of matter, okay? Weight is the force of gravity. Earth's gravity is different than the moon. So your weight will be different on the moon. Your mass will not. Mass is measured, of course, with a balance, and there's a bunch of different types of balances. You have analog balances where there might be little tick marks that you have to measure. And then just like the ruler, you kind of have to see where the mass lines up in those tick marks. Digital balances are what's used probably most commonly today, and often in the laboratory we have those where it specifies the uncertainty exactly on the device. So it'll say 0.005 with some uncertainty. Another type of measurement we might do is volume, the amount of space occupied by matter in an object. That is its volume. Volume has units of maybe cubic centimeters, cubic meters, liters. Those are typical metric units of volume. It can be measured by a bunch of different devices, right? We have this teeny tiny Erlenmeyer flask here that can measure volume. It has a certain uncertainty associated with it. You can have beakers. I also have a whole collection of tiny glassware. That's a tiny beaker. Here's shown graduated cylinders, volumetric flask, and a syringe. And so you can see these have markings on it, and the precision of those markings dictates what the uncertainty is. Right? So in science, we always have uncertainty. We're really never 100% sure of anything. Based on the previous video in the scientific method, we collect data, we make a hypothesis, And in the same manner, we might collect data here and state a uncertainty level. Right? We're never 100% sure even the sun is going to rise the next day. We might be 99.999 out to 90 decimal places sure, but there's a little bit of uncertainty there. So scientists always sort of couch their measurement with this uncertainty. That's how we do it in science. So that's going to do it for this video. Follow me on YouTube, and you can subscribe to my videos there, or you can watch me on Twitch weekly, where I have office hours to answer any chemistry questions you might have, or we just talk about science news over there as well. So see you next time.